don't ever underestimate the value that you could bring or the skills that you have, because someone out there needs the skills you have, and someone is definitely willing to pay for it as well. What's good, people? Welcome to another episode on my channel. It is your boy, Elijah. If you're new here, thank you for coming in. Thank you for tuning in. So we are always talking about investments and different things you should invest your money in, from different companies to cryptocurrency and so on and so forth. So today I wanted to talk a little bit more about why you should invest in yourself. So just to give you a little context, I have three more semesters left in college. So last year, right around May 2020, I started my first kind of venture. It kind of started as a freelance opportunity, but it eventually became my first business. So just to break things down a little bit. So back in May, when the lockdown happened from the COVID-19 pandemic, a lot of what I saw was a lot of restaurants in my neighborhood specifically didn't have a website to order from, and a few of them didn't have their listings on Uber Eats or DoorDash and so on and so forth. And I was kind of curious why that was the case. So I drove down to a couple restaurants with one of my friends, now my business partner, and we were speaking with the business owners, asking them questions like, you know, why don't you have a website, you know, things like that. And a lot of them just said they didn't have it because they just didn't find somebody that could do it for a reasonable price, and they couldn't manage it and things like that. So we had a beautiful idea together, and we said, okay, I'm a computer science student, and I've built websites before. My friend also knows how to build websites and manage stuff. So we sat down together, we're like, okay, we have this opportunity to build something, you know, where it really matters for somebody that could use it. So we came together, put the business together, bought a server, and we were able to build a bunch of websites and, you know, give it to these businesses. So just to give a little bit of more context, so my first customer actually, it was pro bono, and my experience was terrible. So just kind of wanted to give you more clarity on how things could go. And I worked with this client for about a month and a half, and I would say today the only thing I got from that was experience in building the website, because that website didn't go anywhere. The owner didn't use it. The owner didn't just kind of didn't communicate with me at all, so it kind of got wasted. But overall, it was learning experience for me to build a website, but also to get something that could be a finished product out. So then moving forward, we eventually actually made more progress over time, and we were able to eventually get a client that could give us $1,000 a month, which was really, really amazing at the time. Now, that's not the point of me sharing that story. The point was to kind of show you how things could go. So starting off, I didn't even think we could ever get to a position where we could get a client like that. But when we first started, it was pro bono work. We were doing a lot of stuff for free, trying to get more work done so we could get more referrals and kind of have credible work to kind of show other clients that could possibly pay in the future. So this client actually, you know, over time we were, you know, got more work, got more referrals, and we were able to get more clients that were willing to pay us over time. So then, you know, eventually I would say we were able to benefit a lot from this, me and my business partners. We were even able to take a trip to Florida, where we just had a lot of fun together and just had a good time. So, you know, things like this are beneficial over time. Even now, this business today pays me and my business partner live together, so this business pays our rent, which is really nice, and our other bills in the house. So we're able to benefit from this experience. So over time, I would say, you know, first of all, it's scary starting something new, but you know, it pays off over time, and it, you know, just with your dedication and you know nurturing this thing over time, it eventually gets where you want it to be. So now I'm in a position where, you know, I just got into another investment, hoping to start another business in e-commerce very soon. So I'll talk more about that in the future. But for now, you know, I would say that first business gave me more experience, more knowledge, and more confidence in myself to venture on my own and do something that I am, you know, I could be proud of. So my message to you today is, if you've ever thought about any of your skills and you know, you could draw, you're an artist, you can use a computer, you're a good writer, you can cook well, I would say any of these skills today, in the world we live in, you can use these skills to your advantage. So always be finding a way to kind of leverage them in a way that makes your life more beneficial for yourself and however you want to do it. Kind of craft your own career in a sense. So, I mean, a lot of people are freelancing online. So, you know, it's basically freelancing. So my first business I was just talking about, we started off really as freelancing. We're freelancers. We just, I just brought in another person that was really interested in the same thing, and we built a system around this. And that's what really made us, put us in a better position. So we were able to leverage getting designers to help us design websites, you know, developers to help us develop websites, and a few other logistical things. And we just managed the product, which was, you know, managing people, making sure communication was good, and making sure delivery was perfect. And that was our job. So I would say eventually you get to the position where you're leveraging the system, because I'm a full-time student, so I don't have time to necessarily run the business, I would say, of like building websites every day, but our team does, and I know my position and my role in the team, and I'm able to do that with the time I have. So whatever works for you, you can always try to find a way to make it work for you. So I would say eventually it becomes a system, and you know, first of all, it's not gonna start that way, but over time you figure out what works for you, what doesn't, and then you just make it work however you can. So also, I want to say this is also going to line your pockets up really nicely, because, you know, it's going to give you that extra side income that you can use to invest. If you want to invest in the stock market, I'll have some tips on some value stocks you should be investing in the long term. Check out some of my other videos if you want to see the other investments I've already talked about. But also, I do want to say I hope this encouraged you to start or find something of your own. I know this is a quick video, quick and short, but I just wanted to let you know that, you know, it's possible. I would say this right now because I didn't think it was a year ago, but, you know, I kind of dove into it. I was like, okay, you know, what's the worst thing that could happen? You know, I don't get a client, or, you know, that's, you know, you got it. There are a lot of people out there that need something. There are a lot of problems that you could help solve. So don't ever underestimate the value that you could bring, or the skills that you have, because someone out there needs the skills you have, and someone is definitely willing to pay for it as well. So just want to say thank you for stopping by. Thank you for tuning in. I will be letting you know about more investments that I'm making personally. So investments in my business. So this business I was talking about was a digital marketing business, and it helped me a lot with e-commerce. So I'm going into e-commerce, my second business, really soon, and I'll have more updates about how that's gonna go. But I've managed e-commerce websites through my first business, so I have a little bit of experience there. I'm just, you know, now venturing on to build my own and kind of see how that goes. So, you know, I would say other things like the stock market as well, and cryptocurrency, and any other investment that I'm not saying right now, but you can think of and you value. So we're going to be sharing those things with each other. I hope this helped you, or I hope this kind of got you thinking of something you could possibly be doing, or I hope this was just entertaining. So thanks for stopping by. It was your boy Elijah bringing you more videos about how to invest your time. So thank you, and I will see you next time. Peace.